Alrighty, we're going to be installing this beautiful ceiling fan in a drop ceiling. I'm working on a clubhouse that's in a very nice luxury apartment complex. So, here in the country I was born in, we use 14 American wire gauge on 15 amps, 12 American wire gauge on 20 amps. Black is live, white is neutral, the bare of the green is the ground. And we'll start with taking this. We'll get it ready to go in our box here. I'll take one of these out here. So we only need to have one. I'll take the other one out. So the wire is going to come in from the side like this. So I'll get our box centered here so it's in the center. So I'll draw our hole about right here. That'll be about, let's see, where's the center from here? So I'll just come back a little bit. Okay, so we'll put our, we'll open up a opening for our wire here. We'll put our clamp in here. Ground screw to go down through here. Okay, so for the metal box, we have to put a ground screw in and bond our ground wire to the box. Let's go get some screws. This is our green screw to bond the ground wire to the box. Well, if I don't find it, I'll just go grab another one. Well, I'm just going to grab another one. I'm not going to frustrate. I'm not going to carry on. Easier, getting another one is easier, so that's what you do. You don't get upset. Enjoy how that falls over. Thank you, I enjoy that. There we go, we got our box on here nice and solid. So this piece here is the part that's going to hold our fan up here, and we're going to use, we bought some bigger 632 screws. They have a nicer head on them. They're bigger. They'll hold it more sturdy. They're more durable than these screws here. find that green screw. I'm not getting upset. I'm just going to go grab another one. And I don't see it. Oh, here it is. So this is our green screw that's going to bond our box. So we'll put it right in here like this. And we'll put our fan bracket on this here. And these two 632 screws have a bigger head than the screws that are on the box, that come with the box. So we're going to get one, two, and if you want, you could always use a washer to give it a little extra support. I like to use a washer. Got a couple washers out here. Put them on, so now you can see it's going to hold the fan nice and tight up here. And I'll finish it by hand so I don't strip the holes out. Okay, we got it down nice and close, so we'll just get this centered here on our box and tighten our screws up. Take these off because after we hook our fan up, we're going to put our hold our canopy up with these screws. Okay, so we'll get our Romex jacket stripped here. Rip the end here. our wire is coming in from this side, so I'll bring this up this way. Bring it up here. This way. This. Bring it like this. Make sure the cable is coming straight in so it's not pinched on the sides there. Okay, now I'll bring my ground wire up here. Now I'll bond to our box. I gotta tighten that screw a little bit more. Goes around our screw with direction our screw turns there. So we have our ground bounding to our box here. And so can make sure our copper is under the screw head all the way around, which it is. So we have our white, which is neutral, our black, which is live, our green wire, which is the ground. Make sure that's tight there. I'm going to push this wire in a little bit further here. Okay, now I'm ready to get our fan and hang it up here. So I'm just going to wrap it around here a couple times. Get this over towards the center, but I'm going to slide it this way to make it easier to work on. Okay, so I'm going to let it hang by this wire here. Now we'll get our wires stripped and ready to hook up. Okay, so we'll clip our two number 12s. Okay, we'll strip them with our number 12 hole. Hit it with the 14 hole, so you cut it back. Hit it with the right hole. And we have our ground wire here. I'll strip it back a little bit further. Okay, this is the wire for our motor. This is the black wire. So we'll strip it with our 16 gauge hole. The blue one is for our light, and we'll strip that with our 16 gauge hole. I strip it off quite a bit of nice long distance here so I can get a nice even wrap around the solid wire. I'm going to take a little more off the blues. They're about the same length. And the white is our neutral wire for both the fan and the light. So now I'll go down and get our wire nuts and I'll hook our connections up. Okay, so we will take our green wire, which is our ground. We'll get our up near the top here. We'll get our can slice them near the very top of the wire there. I'll bend them down like this, wrap them around our solid wire so that our, get them even at the end so our wire nut grabs both conductors. We'll just stick it on here like this. Make sure it goes nice and tight. And now we can put it up into our box. And above our way here. Now we'll take our black wire, and since they're both controlled by the same switch, we'll put our black and the blue both on the black wire. So we take our strands like that, get our insulation even at the bottom like this, and we'll wrap our strands around that solid wire like that. And then I'll take my black wire, get the insulation even at the bottom, bring them around and wrap them around the pair of all the strands there, get them all even at the end and our insulation even at the top. Take our yellow wire nut, make sure insulation goes up into the bottom of our wire nut, and we'll just tighten it up like that, and we can fold it up into our box like this. Okay, now last we have our white wire, which is the neutral wire for both the fan and the light. We'll get our insulation even at the top like this, bring our strands down like that, we'll wrap them around our solid wire like that here. See how the insulation's even at the top and our copper's even at the end of there. Take our wire out, put it on like this. Make sure it goes on nice and tight like this. And if it doesn't tighten, you just take it off. You don't frustrate, you just take it off. And you just do it again. So just do it again. I'm going to strip it a little longer so we get more. Okay, so here we go again. We'll get our insulation up here like this. Wrap our strands around the solid wire like this. That on. There, it feels like it tightened up nice. No, it didn't. So you know what? We're going to go down to an orange wire nut. I'm just going to leave them twisted. They're even. The insulation's even at the bottom and our copper's even at the top. So we're going to just go down to an orange wire nut. Okay, they're still even, and we went down to the orange, so you see our insulation went up into the bottom of the wire nut. Okay, it tightened up nice and tight, like that. And our insulation went up into the bottom. So now we can put our white wires up into our box here. Get them up out of the way. Now I'm going to look at our notches here to see which holes are like a bayonet mount, so I'm going to take two screws. I'm going to use this one. Okay, so this one's a bayonet mount. So I'm going to put this screw in. And I'm going to put one on the other side, opposite of it. opposite hole here. Stick it in. Go. Okay, so we have our two holes to mount our hang our bracket into. So now we can take hold our mounting wire down. Okay, so now we can set it up here, get our wires all to go up into the box where we want them. Get them all up into that box there. Get our two mounting holes. Okay, so I got two screws ready to go on this side. So put this one in. I used one of the flathead screws because that was the only one we had because we lost the other one. Okay, we'll get our wire up out of our way here. Get it centered. It's nice and solid there. Get our fan centered on our in our cross pieces here, and we'll get ready to set our reptile down in here and put it up. Okay, so what we're going to have to do is cut a reptile in half. And it'll just come down the middle like this. And since we don't have a box to cut out our hole, we're just gonna have to estimate it. And we will not get upset by not having what we need. Just go without. If you don't have it, you go without it. So we're just gonna do the best we can estimating it. Just cut about half of a 4-inch circle out here. Okay, now we'll put our two halves up. Fit right in there. Nice. So the reptile will go down the rest of the way here. So we're going to cut a little bit more here. there's no wire on this side, so I don't have to worry about cutting the wire. We are ready to put our fan blades on. Okay, our fan blades, we put them on off camera on the wood piece here. You can either put the dark side down or the light side. We put the light side down because it looks nicer. Okay, so just tighten our two Phillips screws here. I'm going to get the rest of my screws here. Rest of our blades. We're missing one of these fan blade screws, so it's either a 1032 or a 1232. So I'm going to have to take one to a hardware store. I have one size written down, so I know which one I have to get. And they all have a little lock washer you gotta put in them. So it keeps the blade from loosening up and coming off. We're going to have one just being held with one blade for right now. Or one blade held with one screw for now until we go and get another one. It's not going, but we're not going to get upset, we're not going to frustrate, we're not going to carry on. Just get another one now. Something doesn't fit, it doesn't fit. If something's not meant to be, it's not meant to be. Why bother getting frustrated? So we're going to leave two of them with only one screw for now because I have one in my pocket to go to the hardware and get it matched up. I'm pretty sure it's 1232. The 1032 is just slightly too small. Well, I went through the box that the fan came in, and guess what? I found the screw that I couldn't find down under the flap inside the box, so we are fortunate. So fortunately now we do not have to go to the store and buy another one. Now I can just go down through and make sure they're all tight. Okay, one, two, three, four, we made sure we got them all tight. Now we're ready to put our globes on. We just don't have the bulbs to put in here. So these globes are just held in with these plastic rings here. So we'll just stick our, see how the porcelain is threaded here? We'll just take a plastic piece, we'll just screw it on the inside here. Snug there. But not too tight because you don't want to break the socket in the porcelain. Okay, we don't have any light bulbs, so we'll turn our fan on and see how nicely it blows some fresh air around in here. Alrighty, peace. Thanks for watching. That is how to install a ceiling fan in a drop ceiling here in the country I was born in. I made sure our piece of plywood that our box is screwed to well overhangs these two cross pieces, so it's up there nice and stable, and the two halves of the reptile will keep it from wobbling back and forth.